Are you looking for a simple, cheap tool for capturing your screen, recording your webcam, and editing your videos? Screencast-o-matic is a great answer. The software works on both Macs and PCs, and the cost is just $15 a year. It's not my favorite editing tool. ScreenFlow for Mac is my favorite. But for the money and flexibility, it's a great bet. I'm Brighton West, and in this video, I'm going to share an overview of Screencast-o-matic. So Screencast-o-matic is software that you can run over the internet. And so you would start out best by opening a browser. This works on a Mac or a PC, and go to screencast-o-matic.com. And it will pull up this screen here. And as you can see, you can do a little run through of the features here. You can start a recording right away, or you could go pro for just $15 a year. It's actually a really great deal. I'm gonna go down and look at some of the features, the differences between the free and the pro features. Still, you're gonna get a 15-minute recording time with the free version. You can capture your screen and your webcam. You can publish direct to YouTube, or you can save as a video file, and then you can publish that wherever you want to. Now, with the pro features, there's gonna be no watermark. So on the free version, when you save out your file, it's gonna say Screencast-o-matic, I think, on the bottom of the file. So people will be able to see that you use Screencast-o-matic. Your recordings can be longer. You can record the computer audio from Windows only. You start to get the editing tools and a couple other features here. Some additional places where you can save your file directly, but I usually just save as a video file first before I upload it somewhere else. So I actually have the Pro Recorder, so I'm gonna go directly to the Pro Recorder. And just so you know, you can get this to be on your computer so that you can use it offline. You have to start off online, but you'd go to screencastomatic.com/download and then download the install, and so that works on a Mac or a PC. But I'm just gonna stick with doing this online. I'm gonna log in and click log in. And now across the top here, we've got a couple of options. We can start a new recording, we can look at the old recordings, or we can do that install download that I've just mentioned. But why don't we start with just something brand new? So let's click with start recording. And you'll see it's launching the recorder on the bottom of the screen. And you might have to click allow or okay or something at this point. So you might have to start and download, and then once again, after it's downloaded, you try again, and it will have installed everything it needs. And now I can say launch application. So it's gonna give you a couple of extra messages the first time you do this. So Screencast-o-matic allows you to record a couple of different things. One is your screen, so if you're doing a PowerPoint presentation or something like that, you can also record from your webcam on your computer, or you can do both at the same time. And you can set up a couple of options here in terms of what size you want. Make sure that your microphone, you've got some options here to select a different microphone. Make sure it's working, you've got the green bars coming across. And a couple other preferences, but I'm just gonna record from my screen this time and not from my webcam. And so I'll go and I can position, this is my screen recording box that you see here. So I can choose an area that I wanna record. Maybe I just wanna record that area. And then when I'm ready to record my screen, I push the record button. It gives me a little countdown. And now it's recording what's inside this little box on my screen. And if I had chosen the webcam option, it would be recording my webcam at the same time. So then I can click the pause button, and I could start the recorder again and continue, or I can click done, or if I really didn't like what I did, I could just go ahead and delete it right away. I'm gonna click done. And it pops up to show you what you just recorded. So I'm gonna do a quick play here.
And now it's recording.
So you can see the option there, how things are going. You can see the mouse moving around that little area on the screen. And I can go directly to save it as a video file. I can upload to Screencast-o-matic. They do have, it's kind of like YouTube. You could upload directly to Screencast-o-matic. I'm not sure why you would use that though. And you can come up here and choose one of the other services that if you want to go directly to one of those services. And what you can also do is go down here to edit. So there's some basic editing. You can trim the beginning and the end of the file here, but I think we should go into edit and this will allow you to edit. So you've already been able to record either with your webcam or record what's going on your screen, and now Screencast-o-matic is going to let you do some editing to what you recorded. So you can move this around. It's a little different than some other editors. So you've got a timeline along the bottom. So this is what I recorded, and you can kind of see there, that's exactly what the movements that I did. And what this kind of mountain range here is your voice as you were speaking, or the computer audio if you were on a PC. So you can see kind of the areas where you got quiet or where you stopped, and the areas where you were loud. So it's really pretty helpful. I want to go in here and do something to this. I'll click on the down arrow next to tools here. Quite a number of different things that are possible. So I'm just going to go through a few of them. So the first thing is I'm going to cut out kind of this beginning here. So what I do is I get to this point and I click on cut, and then I drag the bar to say what I want to cut. And you can kind of see that little red there. And you can do a preview if you want to make sure that you cut the right piece. So I'm going to say okay. And you can see that first little bit went away. And now let's say I want to do a different tool to start here. So I want to hide the cursor in the beginning. So I'll go through here and you can see that this is turning orange, showing that the cursor is hidden. And now if we scroll back and forth, you can see no cursor here. And here the cursor comes back on the screen. And you can set some of these kind of for globally if you want no cursor at all during your entire presentation. And what it's doing is it always suggests the last editing tool that you use. So it's kind of like a quick way to do that. You can change the speed, slow it down, speed it up, have transitions if you have different clips going together, or if you did have to cut out something in the middle. So there are quite a number of options of editing tools, and you should probably just get in here and really play around with this. So the other thing that you can do is to change what you're seeing on the screen. And say you need to, you know, crop out something or zoom into a different area. So let's just click on the main window. And you can see this shows up, so I can resize and crop. So I'm going to start with a resize and show you what that looks like. So if I grab the edge here, it's changing this on the screen. So you might be able to have multiple things on the screen at one time. Or I can go to crop, where it's going to cut off this side of the screen. Let's see if you've got some extra there. And you can use those together. Say you want to, you know, do the crop first. Crop. There we go. And then you want to resize it up so that it fills the screen again. Lots of options there. Different styles in terms of, you know, whether you want to have a shadow on this. So if I scroll this up, you can't see because it's got a black background. And you can also change the opacity. So if you have something going on in the background and you just want a little bit of a, you know, something over the top, you want to be able to see through to the background, you can change the opacity down here. Once you're happy with your video, you can click the Done button and then save as a video file. And you've got a number of options here. I usually give it a good file name, but recording number one will work for now. Decide where I'm going to put it. So you can put this, I'm going to suggest, like maybe on your desktop. Hopefully you've got something a little more organized than that. You can decide if you want that cursor to be highlighted or just the cursor. So that's that little yellow circle around the cursor. I'm just going to go with just the cursor. How high you want the quality, then click publish. And what this will do is this will save it out to your hard drive. And now you can go to, you know, the browse folder and see that it's there. And you could open that up and you'll see the video that you recorded, and then you can take that and take it over to YouTube, take it over to Vimeo, take it over to Facebook. You've got lots of options, but this is a pretty simple software to use for recording videos, for editing videos. You can take a video here and actually edit in. If I'm editing, I can insert another video that I've got. So let me do a tools. I can insert a video file from my computer. So let me take something that's not too big. Say okay. And now I actually can go in here and Looks like I need to do a little bit of moving stuff around to get it back into view. This is a video that I took on my iPhone, so this is not limited to things that you record in Screencast-o-matic. You can take images or video from elsewhere and pop it in here and do your editing and save it out from there. Or you can combine things together and combine a presentation or PowerPoint with a video that you shot. So lots of options on this pretty exciting software, especially considering that the pro version is just $15 to get all of these options.
Great software. I have a link below for you to give it a try. You can use the free version forever or unlock the more professional features for just $15 a year. I've got a few videos about Screencast-o-matic. You can check those out by clicking on the screen now.